Coach Giggs here, and today's message, confidence and control. Confidence and control. I'm excited to bring to you a series of messages with people who are extremely special people, and I think you're going to enjoy them. And my first guest here is Zach Hart. Zach, good to have you.
Pleasure. Pleasure's mine.
Welcome
pleasure
to the locker room. I know Zach many, many years. How long now have you been with American Income?
12 years, since I was 18, so.
18 years old. Yeah. Kind of like me. Started at 21, even younger than I did. Good for you. So here we are. You're at our national convention. You've qualified for it. A lot of your people have qualified for it. And in this subject of confidence and control, before we get to it, what motivates you, Zach? What inspires you every day?
You know my family. Beautiful wife, four children, 10, 8, 4, and 1, all boys. So almost like WrestleMania. Wow. At WrestleMania every day at my house. Keeps me on my toes. But family, the Lord obviously always motivates me. But the ability to give, you know, the ability to give to get back, the ability to have passion to change lives, whether it's educational, whether it's mentally, physically, spiritually. But, you know, money's a byproduct of life, and money usually motivates people. But, you know, with what we do, money will come naturally. Okay. So the ability just to change lives in a positive way and to make a difference is what motivates me.
So that motivates you. 100%. Seeing other people learn from you, whatever it is that you need to teach them, and seeing them change.
Absolutely. Being an educator.
I love it. Well, and you know why that is? And that's why you're a leader. Because this is the heart I have found of leaders, is that they want to share, they want to educate, they want others to know. So, and God knows, four children, boys.
That's
oh
right.
My God.
That's right.
Thank you, Lord. I have one girl, not four boys. But WrestleMania, I love it.
That's true.
I love it. Okay, so now let's get to the core of the message. Confidence and control. Explain this to everyone out there. I know this is important to you, and that's today's message. Confidence and control. Explain this.
Right. Well, you know, nobody likes to be a loser. Whether it's the so to have confidence to wake up. I wake up winning. I wake up every single morning knowing that I wake up every morning saying I win. I win. And it's not about thinking that I'm the best at something. It's the ability that because the Lord gave me the ability to wake up.
Okay.
If you're given the ability to wake up, I have a statement at everything I do, and it's not have a good day. Have a good day. It's make it your best day. Because my philosophy on life is if you make every day your best, absolutely, every day your best, as if it's your last. Make every day your best as if it's your last, eventually, you're going to be right, no matter what.
Wow.
So the ability to have the confidence, but the control. Not the confidence, Eric, that people walk around with cocky. Not the ability to say, I'm confident to the point where I'm going to sit on a golf course and beat Tiger Woods.
Right.
But the ability to be confident to the point where you can just wake up knowing that you're going to be great at something. Because opportunity that day is never lost. It's just going to be taken by somebody that's quicker, faster, willing to work harder than you at something that day.
Wow.
And that's the ability of confidence. But believing in you. Believing in you and believing in the people that taught you how to be there. I mean, success isn't always about money. It's about how successful you can make other people. And some of the most little recognized people, and unfortunately the most probably underpaid people, are ministers and teachers. And that's what we have the ability to do, is to
always
educate.
And the most important people, too. They're so
sure,
important
100%.
People.
And what they do is they change one life. And if that life can change 1,000. So what I do is I wake up every single morning just telling myself I won. And it's the ability, because I woke up. That's it. So the ability to have confidence to change lives, to educate others.
Now the control part.
Mm-hmm.
Talk briefly just about the control part, because I know for you, you have an amazingly successful group of people.
Mm-hmm.
That doesn't just happen.
No.
Tell me about this control part and how that ties into the success of your people.
You know, confidence is one thing, but with confidence, you naturally have to be able to control the situation. You know, one thing about control is control isn't always just telling and directing and guiding. Leading in so many different ways. You know, one thing that I used to do is I was never a good follower, which impacted me not to be the best leader. But then when I found the right people to lead, my motto at that point in time was, it's better to listen to good advice than always just give advice.
So
with the control aspect, you really have to know the ability of what you're doing. So now it's, you know, I may not agree with everything everyone has to say, but I'm going to listen to everything, because everybody has a voice. There's no such thing as a low-level individual.
Right.
So to control the situation, but to give them the opportunity to speak freely, hold freely, but to also let them know when, hey, listen and take direction.
Very cool.
Is the most important
thing. What advice, as we close out this locker room segment, what advice would you give to those people who deep down inside, they want your success, they want your confidence, they want your ability to control their lives? What advice would you give to the millions of people out there on how they can grow more confident and more in control? What advice would you give?
You know, the biggest confidence I have in that situation, Eric, would have to be you. Just believe in you. Because the ultimate barrier and the ultimate obstacle in life, no matter what the circumstances are, whether it's being a good person or whether it's having strong integrity, character, confidence, control, is you. It's always going to be the individual
yourself.
So
if I want more confidence and I want more control, I gotta learn to believe in myself.
100%. 100% in you. Okay. And listen to your support systems. You know, listen to your support systems 100%.
Okay.
Your moms, your dads, your brothers, your sisters, the Lord, whomever that motivating factor is that's going to help you get to that next level of life, which is enjoyable every single second of the day. But just believe in you ultimately. That's what I tell my people. Just be you today, baby, because you're beautiful.
Very good. Very good. There it is. You have it, folks. Well, I hope you enjoyed this locker room visit with Zach Hart and myself. Zach, thank you so much for sharing that. You're awesome.
You're
awesome. We'll see you guys later. Welcome to the locker room. We'll see you later.
Yeah.
Wow.
If you know someone you feel has a special story to tell or life to share, please email Eric directly and he will reach out to you and or this individual, even if you think this person is you. And by the way, if you've enjoyed and feel the Daily Locker Room has served as an inspiration in your life, why not share it with a friend by sending them the daily message?